One of the most common complaints to the technology today is longevity. Our brand new devices seeming to slow down just after a few years, forcing us to buy new devices frequently. One great example of this is with phones. We commonly have to upgrade phones after just a few years, either them being feeling too slow, or just that the new innovations and offerings are too good to turn down. Although it might be surprising, part of the reason for this can be found in a prediction that is over 50 years old. In 1965, a man named Gordon Moore predicted that roughly every 2 years, the number of transistors in the same space on microchips will double. Gordon Moore is the co-founder of Intel, one of the largest processor makers in the world. In fact, you likely have a device with the Intel processor at your house right now. The basis of this prediction lies in what a transistor is. A transistor can be seen as the building block of processors and microchips. In microchips, a transistor essentially depends. The number of transistors essentially determines the speed and power of what that chip is, the power of that chip. Meaning that Moore was predicting that computer performance would almost double every 2 years. Remarkably, this prediction has almost held up for 50 years now, and the facts of this exponential growth of transistors are present in our everyday lives. Like I mentioned earlier, this is part of the reason why our phones always seem slow. Software is always being created for the newest devices, and since the speed and power of new devices is always increasing exponentially, the software will not be able to be run or will be extremely slow on older devices. And considering how fast the speed of devices is increasing, older devices will struggle to keep up. An example of this can be seen at school. Chromebooks and laptops, bought only a few years ago, struggled to keep up with new demanding software being used in schools all around the country. However, Moore's Law has still brought about many significant benefits for humans. The rapid increase in computer performance has increased the quality of life for many around the world, and also has allowed information to be easily accessible. Many devices such as smartphones and tablets can now access tons of information and run what was thought to be complex software for complex machines. However, at this moment, we are currently at a crossroads. I once guided the growth and power of processors for decades, maybe finished forever. In 2019, the CEO of NVIDIA, one of the largest chip makers in the world, Jensen Huang, said that Moore's Law is dead. Even to 2020 and 2021, there's been even more concern that Moore's Law is nearing its end. Advancements in shrinking the size of transistors are seemingly slowing down, even as money being poured into the research and development of transistors is steadily increasing. So what does this mean for us? One area this could affect is electronic waste. If the speed of advances is increasing less as years progress, then people will have less incentive to upgrade their devices. Upgrading their devices means they have to throw out old ones, and all of these old and outdated devices create waste. So as more and more people have less incentive to upgrade their devices due to less technological investments, waste will likely decrease. In addition, we could also save thousands of dollars, as we'll save pressure to upgrade to new devices. In addition, the end of Moore's Law could be a reduction in the speed of technological advancements all around the world. Over the past years, we have seen an immense amount of progress. A great example of this is phones. Compare the flip phones seen maybe even 50 years ago to the smartphones we have today. The rate of the advancement of technology has been at a blistering pace over the recent years. However, if Moore's Law is indeed dead or dying, that means that the rate of technological advancements will likely decrease as processing power and speeds are also decreasing. The rapid pace of advancement currently seen may never be seen again, as the gains in processing power slow. Even if Moore's Law is dying, the impact of this prediction cannot be understated. For a prediction made over 50 years ago to still be accurate is remarkable by itself. But more importantly, Moore's Law has guided innovation and progress for decades, and its impact will be felt for decades more to come. Thank you.